matters to Jannah.
Assalamu alaikum guys, and welcome to another episode of Smile to Jannah. Just wanted to give you guys a quick little reminder, Ramadan reminder, that's right. Let's take the analogy of people that in first class. A guy goes in first class and he sees a person that, how did you get into first class, mate? Oh, I've been accumulating all these points and I finally qualified for first class. Another guy says, yeah, we came late and my wife's not feeling well, so to give her more space, they allowed us to come first class. Another guy says, oh, this was a gift from our brother. Another person might say, I don't know, we know the pilot. So whatever the reason may be, when it comes to people that are in first class, they have different reasons. Yeah, they have different reasons why they're in first class. It will be the same when we get to Jannah. When we get to Jannah, there'll be different deeds and there'll be different reasons why people have entered Jannah. One person may say, I entered Jannah because I gave water to a dog. Simple as that. We know this from the hadith. A really bad woman, once she saw a thirsty dog, she took off her leather sock, filled it with water and gave it to the dog. Allahu Akbar, she got forgiven. And another woman tied up a cat and just watched it struggle and die. And Allah hated this action so much that this was the means for her to enter the hellfire. So we know this, guys. Yeah, we know. You never know which deed it will be. So never underestimate, guys, what deed it is. And don't trivialize your deeds, because sometimes, guys, nobody might be around to appreciate what you're saying or what you're doing, but Allah does. Allah appreciates it. Why? Because you're doing it for His sake. And that's why Ramadan is so special. Allahu Akbar. All it takes when you're doing wudu, swallow. No one's going to know. Ramadan is something that's between you and Allah. Salah, people can see you pray. Dhikr, they can hear you mutter something. Quran, they can see you read. But fasting is something that's between you and Allah. That's why Allah has not prescribed a specific reward for fasting. Yeah, the reward for fasting, Allah's kept open, which means the reward is Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. That's why, guys, it's very important that we carry on doing what we can. And sometimes, subhanallah, yeah, you might be doing something really big, but that's not why you're going to get Jannah. Yeah, that's not why you're going to get Jannah. So may Allah give us the ability to understand and appreciate these things. That's why I would say, even with your kids. Yeah, when I was a teacher, I wouldn't constantly reward my kids. Yeah, because when you do that, it's like a Scooby snack. You know, Scooby-Doo? He gets all gassed up just because he gets a Scooby snack. Or Shaggy, or a Scooby snack. Yeah, he gets all excited. But let's not constantly look for Scooby snack. Let's do stuff genuinely for the pleasure of Allah. And that's why it's important for us to increase our love for Allah and not just want Jannah. Yeah, I want Jannah, mate. I want Allah to do this, I want Allah to do that. Well, is this some sort of business partnership you got with Allah? You make a dua, you do a specific action, or Allah needs to accept your dua now. What's this? What's this? Yeah? So bear this in mind, guys. Let's use the Ramadan to increase our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to do that, know about Him. And the more you know Allah, the more, Allahu Akbar, your relationship will become stronger. And if you fix your relationship with Allah, Allah will fix your relationship with everything and everyone else. Let's leave it there, guys. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum.